is my haul. Disclaimer, this is just part one. So these are some of the washi tapes and pens and small stuff that I got. So let's start. I got this set of notebooks. These are mini notebooks. There's actually also a green one, which I gave to my friend. It's really cute and handy. And I think this fits an A6 passport. I'm not sure yet, but I liked it because of the old school design, obviously. Next, I got this from the Midori booth. So this is a roll sticker. I think this is a new one that they came out with because it's bigger. And usually they have the smaller ones that are used for packaging and stuff. So I really am looking forward to using this for some of my journal spreads and for gifts. I also went to the Bandai store, as you've seen in the previous clip. So this is one of the new designs that they have. I think it's in line with spring 2020. And then this one is the one that I showed earlier where it's actually a peel-off design. So basically this white part doesn't get in the spread. So you peel it off and you just get the remaining one, which is the actual design. So it's pretty revolutionary, very Japanese style. I also got this clear block from BGM. So the reason why I got this is I got new stamps that have a smaller size. So I think this is gonna be handy also for travels. This one was an impulse buy. I think it was like buy one, take one. But at the back you have two designs of animals. I'm not sure, but anyway, this is what I bought. This is the reason why I bought it, because I don't know, it's just really nice. It's like a thank you envelope, and I really love this like very vintage picnicky design, and I love these colors as well. For washi tapes, I will start with this. This is Kita. It's owned by King Jim. They had this limited edition designed one, so I just had to get it, and I like this aesthetic with the whole like flowers and organic feel, and I like my grid, so yeah, it's gonna be useful for my Hobonichi next year for sure. This is a set of mild liner brush pens. So this design is exclusive for Bungu Joshi. So you see here, Wanchi Nuitsu, I don't know how this is pronounced, but you basically get a case, and then I think they sold it for a cheaper price as well, and then I got the colors that I wanted. You'll notice also the difference between the regular mild liner and this brush one is this is actually a brush tip, so that you'll see it there. But it also has the one at the back where it's just like a normal tip. So obviously I got the ones in my preferred colors, but also these are ones that are great when used for brush lettering. So I'll do more videos on that soon. I had to get this because the design is really nice. So it's a natural garden washi tape cutter from Kokuyo. I think I have like two yellows and one white, but this design really caught my eye because I love yellow and gray combination. So of course I had to get it. This one is actually a freebie from Bungu Joshi. It is a mirror. So if you spend, I think, more than 15,000 yen, lol, you get this freebie. Which is obviously, I spent more, way more than that, but hi, hello. Lastly, we have all of the washies that I got here. Now we will start one by one. So this one is like a die cut style, which I think is really interesting, and I had to get it in this nice shade of pink. So it comes out with this pattern. Next, I got this masking tape from Worldcraft. I don't know what the design is actually. I think it's like Daily Life or something, but it's very interesting. I think it has music, people. I don't know, I like the colors as well, so I had to get it. This one is my personal favorite. It is stationery themed. And I think it's very, very reminiscent of the reason why I went to Bungu Joshi to get these kinds of designs. This one was another impulse purchase, but this is very festive. I would say it has a lot of gold foil details as well, and I love the colors and patterns. I got this one from Papier Platz. So they have a lot of vintage style washi tape, so I wanted to get something minimal that I could add to my spreads and basically just, you know, put them on the sides as borders, and this was very apt for that. This one, I am really into, if you've noticed, most of my haul is either like travel themed or like organic nature themed, so I think this is also one of my picks for that. This one is a limited edition design, I believe. They had two color combinations, but I figured that the red one was really appealing because it had a lot of gold foil designs, as you can see here. It's really, really nice. And I like the elegance of the burgundy color at the background. Of course, I had to get the one that I showed earlier, which is the train washi design. I love trains, and I don't think Japan will ever run out of train design washi tape. So this is from Cyan. It's a very popular washi tape brand as well. This one, I just had to get it also because it's on sale. I got these two for only 100 yen, so that's like 50 pesos. It's really, really cheap. And I got one, of course, in architectural building designs like this. Really, really great. And then this one is more of like, what's the title? Surreal Town. So I really love the color combinations. That's why I ended up getting this as well. And lastly, because I am that person who loves my packaging, I saw this immediately and I'm like, I have to get this. So I got this. I think it's, the quality is heavy, more heavy duty than the usual paper tape. So I might be using this for more of my shipments and basically all of the other things that require this kind of theme or aesthetic. So for part two of my haul, these are actually more of the bigger stuff, but let's start with this one. This is a Midori Marche Lucky Bag that I think they released exclusively for Bungu Joshi. They have four different colors, but basically the stuff inside are, I think they're the same. So first you have this notebook set, which I really love. So there are two different colors but the same design, and then inside one is in yellow and one is in blue. Honestly, I don't know what to do with the blue one because I don't like using colored paper for writing. So personally, my favorite is the one on the left. And then you have this really, really cute matchbox, and I was like, what is this? And then I figured out it's actually clips inside, which are really great. Let me see if I can open it for you. It's so cute! I mean, come on, look at that. So you have notepads, you also have, let's see, basically different like stationery things. It reminds me of like, oops, it reminds me of like Hunger Games pins. But anyway, this is good for journaling and I find it to be really useful, and I really like the design that they did with this one. And then you have this set of washi stickers, which are stationery themed, I believe. It's really, really pretty. And it's very much on brand with Midori in general, so I really love it. I actually don't know if I want to use it. Next, in the, I think, yeah, this was also in the Midori booth, I believe. I saw this notebook and I was like, I want to try it out. It's called Month Year Life. But I have to figure out how the system works, because you can track, like, I think a year's worth here, and then on top you have the day. So if it's like a habit thing or a habit tracker, you can definitely do this. But I'm wondering, since there are a lot of pages, it could probably last me for like a good 10 years, so something I will explore. Next, at the BGM booth, I also got this clear stamp clear book, also because I don't have something that I can use to carry my stamps when I travel, so I think this is really perfect. And then here at the back you can actually put in your clear blocks and some inks. And of course I got a really nice gray color because I am that kind of person. With regards to stamps, I think, yeah, I got three stamps here. So first of all, I got this BGM one for my monthly and weekly planning. I actually like this one, so I want to see how this works, and also the time. So I've yet to work on this, but I am really up for anything that is very organized and scheduled. So I'm very excited to use this. I got two from the Papier Platz booth. Actually, this one I got from the Blue Collar. Actually, this one I got from the Blue. Actually, this one I got it from the Blue Collar Craft Workshop, where Papier Platz also had a booth, but it's also available at the booth in Bungu Joshi. So this one, if you see up close, it's actually travel themed, and a lot of like lifestyle stuff with the post delivery and stuff, and I can hashtag relate to everything, so I liked it. And then this one is very much into stationery. I love this Chronicle one, to be honest, so I got them. It's a collaboration with Sakura Lala, who's Eri. I met her during the workshops and Eric Small Things. I will link all their Instagrams down below for your reference. And the last stamp set I got, my concern is actually with the stamps, they come off really expensive for me because I don't use a lot of stamps, like rubber stamps. They're like 1,000 yen for each. So this one is a good deal that I got everything for 1,000. So technically it's just like 250 yen for each stamp, and it has this really nice paper bag with the Bungu Joshi packaging. So I was like, of course I had to get it, and it's really nice for gifts. And I think, yeah, these are some of the stickers I got. So first, of course, I got a travel themed one, and that is Germany, I think. I'm not sure. Anyway, so this is from Cameo Japan. It's a very popular stationery brand. They also have a lot of stuff in Loft and Tokyo Hands. And then these are really pretty index stickers that I got. I have no idea if I'm gonna use them. And also I got this palette sticker sheet from Cameo as well. This one, I just found it really cute because usually when you see like handle with care stickers, they're very like explicit and red, and this one was just like a nice minimal color that I really liked and enjoyed. So yeah, I didn't get a lot of stickers, mostly the washi. This one is a free size book cover, and I like that you can use it in a variety of ways. So I have not figured out what I want to use it for yet, but just a fun fact, in Japan, people don't like it when the books that I read are seen. So that's why they have this book cover. So it's actually paper, but it is 100% waterproof. So I'm looking forward to use it to maybe cover one of the books I'm reading or my journal. So there, they also have a lot of designs, so I really, really liked it. Of course, I also got this. There was a booth there that was all about the notebooks, and of course I got this because it's just so cute. And I also got the tote bag, so it's like a collab between, what is this? I think this is the notebook brand and Cubic, so there. And lastly, this was very much promoted during the event. So when they were like going out of the booth, and they're like, oh, this is on sale, la la la. This is the logo of Bungu Joshi. So this is an exclusive item, and it's in collaboration with Project Paper, which I'm very familiar with because the first time I went to Japan, I bought a pad, and it's really useful for planning, and you have the seal on each page as well. And fun fact, I thought for the longest time that this was an Eiffel Tower. What the heck? Anyway, it's the Tokyo Tower.